Exchange rate regimes are typically divided into three broad categories. On one end of the spectrum, there are hard exchange rate pegs. On the other end, there are flexible exchange rate regimes. The spectrum or degree of exchange rate rigidity is determined by the extent the government intervenes to affect the exchange rate. Hard pegs imply no flexibility of the exchange rate, while floating regimes imply free movement of the currency's price relative to other currencies. In between the two extremes, there is a variety of intermediate exchange rate regimes. Let's talk about each group of regimes in detail. Under a fixed exchange rate, the monetary authority commits to exchanging a unit of foreign currency for X units of domestic currency. X is the exchange rate peg. Some countries go much further than fixing the exchange rate. They adopt the currency of another country. For example, some countries use the United States dollar. These are exchange arrangements with no separate legal tender. Under such a system, the currency of another country circulates as the sole legal tender. This arrangement is also called formal dollarization. Alternatively, a country may belong to a monetary or currency union in which the same legal tender is shared by all members of the union. For example, in the euro area. Adopting such regimes implies the complete surrender of the national monetary authority's control over domestic monetary policy. Another category in the group of hard pegs is currency board arrangements. In this system, the commitment to the fixed exchange rate regime is supported by legislation that makes the peg irrevocable, at least in principle, combined with restrictions on how much currency the central bank can issue. Typically, domestic currency will be issued only against foreign exchange. Some flexibility may still be afforded, depending on how strict the rules of the currency board arrangement are. More generally, having a fixed exchange rate requires the central bank has enough reserves of foreign currency to meet the country's demand for foreign currency. It also limits the central bank's freedom to adjust the supply of domestic currency in the economy, which we refer to as monetary policy. I'll give you an example of a hard peg arrangement. Since October 1983, the Hong Kong dollar has been linked to the United States dollar under a currency board arrangement, the linked exchange rate system. The Hong Kong Monetary Authority committed to buy and sell the Hong Kong dollar at a pre-announced rate. Along with this two-way convertibility undertaking, the Hong Kong Monetary Authority also introduced a symmetric trading band around a central parity. In summary, under hard peg arrangements, countries fix the exchange rate or adopt the currency of another country. Let's discuss another group of exchange rate arrangements. In the middle of the spectrum are soft exchange rate pegs. Soft pegs attempt to mix the stability of a peg and adjustment that come with floating rates. The mixing has been done in a variety of ways. In this group, countries may peg their currencies to another currency or a basket of currencies. However, there is no explicit legal commitment. In some cases, fluctuations may be allowed within a certain range called a band. In a crawling peg arrangement or crawling band regime, the level of the exchange rate as well as the band can be adjusted periodically. To support the soft peg arrangement, countries intervene directly by means of buying or selling foreign exchange or indirectly using other instruments. Under such an arrangement, central banks keep limited flexibility regarding monetary policy. For example, central banks can affect monetary conditions by adjusting the interest rate. This limited flexibility is, however, greater than in exchange arrangements with no separate legal tender and currency boards. The monetary authority can adjust the level of the exchange rate, although relatively infrequently. Let me give you a couple of examples of countries with soft pegs. Nicaragua implements a crawling peg system. Since December 2004, the monthly crawl has been set at an annual rate of 5%. Maintaining a credible crawling peg mechanism imposes certain constraints on other macroeconomic policies, such as monetary and fiscal policy, where these policies have to complement the exchange rate policy. Saudi Arabia is de facto classified as conventional peg. The currency of Saudi Arabia, rial, has been pegged to the United States dollar since 1986. At the other end of the spectrum are floating exchange rate regimes. As the name implies, the floating exchange rate is mainly market determined. In countries that allow the exchange rates to float, central banks intervene through purchases or sales of foreign currency in exchange for local currency, mostly to limit short-term exchange rate fluctuations, rather than to achieve an exchange rate objective. However, in a few countries, for example the United States, central banks almost never intervene to manage the exchange rates. Floating regimes offer countries the advantage of maintaining an independent monetary policy. Independent monetary policy implies monetary autonomy or ability of monetary authorities to influence the country's monetary conditions, that is, supply of domestic reserve money or its price, the interest rate. Let me give you a couple of examples here as well. New Zealand is a country with floating exchange rate regime. The system was adopted in 1985 and authorities remain committed to free floating with only limited interventions by the central bank. Another example is Brazil. Foreign exchange rate regime has been classified as floating since 1999. To sum up, the exchange rate regimes implemented by countries can be divided in two, three broad categories, from hard pegs to flexible exchange rate regimes. The degree of exchange rate rigidity is determined by the extent the countries intervene to affect the exchange rate. Other macroeconomic policies are important to complement the exchange rate policy. Thank you.